The Adelope Synergy Core sound cards have some amazing effects inside. We recently did a video where we compared some of those effects with the hardware that they were modeled after. If you haven't seen that video, the link will be below in the description. But what about the workflow? How easy is it to set it up? Well, let's find out! I have with me the Discrete 4 Synergy Core, which I really like because it is very mobile friendly. I can carry it with me with my laptop easily to the studio, maybe a tour or anywhere else. First, let's launch the Adelope Launcher. So this is where you can check if everything is up to date. Looks like I'm on latest version. And here you can check your plugins, if everything is up to date. If you have any of the microphones such as the Verge, the Edge Solo, the Edge Quattro, the Edge Duo and so on. And here at the system, you can check the drivers. We are running this sound card with USB, so we don't need the Thunderbolt drivers here. Next, let's fire up the control panel. This is where you can control almost everything of your sound card. The internal mixing console, which has very flexible routing, you can do insane stuff with it. First, let me show you something that I find very interesting. So what we have here in the mixer is 16 channels of inputs. Let's go, for example, on inputs 5 and 6. Right now they are set up, so it's computer play 1 and 2. If I click on here, I can select any of the 4 preamps, emulation microphones, computer play up to 16 inputs, 8 DAT inputs, 8 channels of those, 2 of SPDIF, I don't know what the mute is, and oscillator, 2 oscillators. Okay, so if you set it up to computer play 1 and 2, so whatever the computer is playing, it is going to feed it as an input. So you can record it on your Pro Tools. So what I have here in Pro Tools is a stereo audio track. Set the input to 5-6 because 5-6 is here the computer play. And whatever the computer is playing, I can record it. One for your studio? Well, let's find out. I think that is awesome because not many sound cards can do that. Now let's see another scenario. We are recording a vocal. We plug this microphone to preamp 3. Because this microphone is wireless, there is some preamp to it. That's why I have here set it up to line input. But normally you will put a mic input and you can select it from here. Now all I need to record with no latency at all is just to turn on the microphone on the mixing console and make sure I have low latency monitoring set on my Pro Tools session. What is even more cool is that you can use some plugins with it. I made a channel strip here. So first, I have a tube preamp, and this is an emulation of the Telephone Ken 76. Oh yeah, more warmth, more bite. Perfect. Okay, this distorts a lot. Okay, let's take it back. Yeah. Okay, this is cleaner. So next I have a 1073 EQ. I just use it to have some low cut. Here is...
Yay. No lows at all. Low cut at the 300 Hz.
Okay, let's bring it back to 50 Hz. That's nice to take some of the rubble out. Next, here's a compressor I really like because it's very transparent. Let's heat it up a little bit. Yeah. Okay, cool. Just to tame up the, you know, the peaks in case the singer gets loud. Finally, I have this beautiful emulation of the Skyband. So here is much brighter and more presence this way. So when I record now, what will happen is that all those effects are baked in. The effects take a zero hit on my CPU as they are only using the DSP of the sound card. So what happens if you want to have some reverb? You click on Aura Verb and we are on input 3, right? Okay, so what we have to do is hit the send here. It's already sending. So what I need to do is just open the return here and voila, we got reverb. Amazing, right? So from here you can select some presets, I guess. Hey, oh, let's try another one. Oh, hey, oh. You can do some like the reverb time. Woo. Hey, hey. Okay, this is a large reverb. And a small one. Yay. Okay. So this is how you set up your reverb. This reverb is not being recorded to Pro Tools. It's just for listening to it. Okay, let's see now another scenario. Let's say we want to record an electric guitar. Okay, I have connected the electric guitar into the first preamp of the Adeloop. I have set it to instrument input. So here is where you will change it from. This is mic, this is line, and this is instrument. The instrument input, it works like a DI, a direct input. We'll go to the AFX here, and we're going to select a guitar amp emulation and a guitar cabinet emulation, and I have also inserted a gate. We're going to make two channels here inside Pro Tools. The first one is going to be called the wet signal, and let's call this guitar wet. Wet is the distorted sound. Second channel, guitar dry. This is the clean signal of the guitar. So we want to record both of those channels at the same time. First one, let's go to in one. That is correct. And the next one, I have to set it up. How about we put it on the seventh input here? Preamp one. If I go here at the seventh input, this is going to be the clean signal. Let's try it out. So we have recorded now two channels. Let me show you why. The above track is the distorted sound. The below track, the dry one, is the clean signal. As you can see, with the clean signal, it is much easier to edit. So if I want to, you know, do some cuts here, over and there, it is much easier to edit whatever I want, because otherwise it will be not very easy with the above waveform. The second reason is for reamping purposes. Okay, let's listen to the dry signal. Okay, so this is how we're going to reamp now the guitar. Let's go to the mixing console. On the fourth input, this is where I'm going to do the reamping. I'm going to use a hardware insert, the fourth one with the I/O. So what that means is that I'm sending this signal to the fourth input of the discrete, and it's going to return back to the fourth input a distorted sound. The routing of the signals can be versatile and complex too. You can have up to 16 inputs and 16 outputs on the discrete 4, but you can select exactly each input that fits your DAW, what will it be. So you can customize it any way you want. Hope this video gave you some insight of how the DSP works. I really enjoyed it every day, and it blows my mind how you can easily record with even a large buffer setting with the effects. So please tell me if you would like to see more videos in the future with plugins reviews. I know most of our previous videos are hardware related, but if you want to see more videos where we test more plugins, then tell me in the comments below. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button to make sure you see new videos as soon as they are uploaded. Thank you for watching this, and stay safe!